Hi drummers, hope you're well. Shout out to channel members Hayley, David and Andy. This is Waterboys, Hole of the Moon.
But
So I hope that all makes a bit of sense. It's just such an amazing song to play through, and I don't know, to in my opinion, just to my view, it's about the most perfect pop song that there is, isn't there? A pop rock bit of funk in their song. So there's a lovely, great video actually I saw on YouTube just now where Chris Whitten, the original drummer who played this, tells the whole story of him playing with the Waterboys and then ending up playing on this. It's really fascinating. I'll link to it below. I really urge you to check that one out if you're interested in this song. And I've heard this song hundreds and hundreds of times and played it at gigs and played it as people's first dance at their wedding and all sorts of cool stuff like that. And always love the drum part. It's a funny thing because it's like, if you're just getting started on the drums, and actually Hayley messaged me the other day and she said exactly this, if you're just getting started on the drums, it is one you can just play along to. So there I'm, you know, following a chart and sort of trying to play pretty much exactly what Chris Whitten did. But you can just groove it, man. It's basically kick, snare, isn't it? So as long as you can play a basic sort of rock pop type of beat, then you're away. Obviously, if you want to go a little deeper and you're a little further down the line with your drumming, it is really fun to try and replicate some of those fills. I always think one of the main reasons to do that is, well, obviously it's cool to sound like it sounded and really capture that vibe and that feel. But then also, every time you study a great drummer, and clearly Chris Whitten is one, when you study a great drummer's stuff, it's a great chance to sort of take their vocabulary and in the nicest way, sort of assimilate it, sort of lovingly nick it, and, you know, maybe reuse it elsewhere. Something he talks about on that video, and I think this is mind-blowing, because I've heard this song so many times and played it, I'd never really put this together, is the influence from Prince. So the band went to see Prince, and he said they came out changed men. And he said that, I was like, of course, man. You listen to the drum part, like some of the sort of open hi-hat and snare drum hits, and it just makes me think of like 1999 or something like that by Prince. And then the keyboard sound, as soon as that comes in, you go, of course, that's the influence, man. It's so funny, isn't it? You can hear a song hundreds, thousands of times, man, for over, you know, all of my life. I'm 41 years old. Like I've heard that song all the time, all over the place. It's just unavoidable, isn't it? In the best way. And I've obviously listened to Prince all my life as well. And suddenly he said that. I was like, of course that's true. And I was astonished. It's just my fault for never having put those two things together. Of course, there's a huge Prince influence going on in it. I think because vocally and because of all the other Waterboys stuff, you sort of associate it with a bit more sort of folk and rock and those sort of styles a bit more. And of course, and Chris Whitten's thing was he was in a funk band before, and he said they were into, did he say Parliament, Funkadelic, that kind of thing. So makes so much sense. And man, as soon as he said that, that came together. So that's really interesting to think about, I think. Like I say, if you're a beginner, you can just sort of jam along to it, and it's a brilliant one to do. For fun, though, I just tried to follow the part. One or two bits I didn't quite get 100%, but whatever. Like, it was close enough that the vibe is the thing on this one, clearly. And like I say, shout out to Hayley, David and Andy for suggesting that one. What I'll do now, over on the channel members page shortly, I'll do a full talk through of that, and I'll go through and talk through some of the fills a bit more and sort of talk about that. I'll also do a little cheat sheet for it. I'll write that out and post that on the channel members page as well. Like I say, shout out to those three for suggesting it. Sorry if I had to hang on a little bit for that. And thanks for watching as always. Really appreciate it. Please like, share and subscribe. If you do subscribe and you're on YouTube and you want to get a notification every time I upload a video, which is pretty much every day, please click the little bell icon. Shout out as ever to all the amazing people who support this channel. If you found these videos helpful or useful or feel positive about them in some way, and you're in a position to and would like to, please consider supporting this channel. You can do that via my Buy Me a Coffee support page, which is linked above or below, depending whether you're watching this on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, or whatever. You can either buy me a coffee. Thanks a million to all the lovely people who do that. It's a single one-off support donation, and I hugely appreciate it. It really keeps me going and keeps this channel moving forward. And then all the amazing channel members, thanks so much. Like I say, Hayley, David, Andy, but all the others as well. As a channel member, you're supporting this channel on an ongoing basis and helping it to grow, becoming an integral part of it. You're also getting a whole lot of stuff in return, ongoing drum support, a personalized practice plan, which I'll update for you as you progress. A complimentary Zoom session or face-to-face session where we can check in and formulate that in the first place. Access to future sessions if you want them. Breakdowns of the drum covers, like I just said, for this one, for example. Talk-throughs of the drum covers that I do. Talk-through videos, but also notation and practice-along versions for the tutorial videos. And I'm on hand for you to answer your questions. I tend to do video responses for that to people who, channel members who ask questions. You get priority. There's a priority sort of request list for future videos on the channel. All the videos that appear now, quite honestly, are the requests from channel members, just to, due to being totally sort of saturated with requests. So I've had to prioritize the channel members' requests. I hope that makes sense. And yeah, a whole lot of other features as well, including channel members send me their practice videos, stuff they're working on, and I'll do video responses as feedback. Do a little thing every day now where I sort of sit, usually at my kitchen table, I watch everybody's practice videos and do video responses. It's really, really fun. So if that sounds like it'd be of interest to you, like I say, details above or below, it's where it says buy a coffee / become a channel member here. Some quick shout outs as well, just while I'm here, thanks so much in the last few days to new channel members, Andy, Phil, Mark, David, Mr. T, and someone. I love a someone when it says somebody became a member. If you don't write your name on that page, that's totally cool. I won't read your name out on here, but somebody, thank you so much. And then just for the coffees, Richard, Yoram, or I hope I'm saying that right. So I hope I'm saying that right. Yoram, Darrow, Ian, Brian, Marky, Stephen, and Darren, just in the last few days. Thanks a million. I appreciate the support so much. I'm so glad if you found the videos useful. And yeah, thanks a million for getting involved and supporting the channel. Appreciate it more than you know. Thanks a million. Shout out to Hayley, David, and Andy. Head over to channel members page now. I'll link to that below. Channel members for a full talk through, which I'll do soon. As see you soon. Thanks a million.